Today is a feast of Saint Apollinaris, Bishop and Martyr. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, amen. Tuae vodat abite.
Amen.
Iudicam et Deus, et Dicam 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 et
Deus, et Dicam et Deus, et Dicam et Deus, et Dicam et Deus, et Dicam
et Deus, et Dicam et Deus, et Dicam et Deus, et servant, that servant in Montem Sanctum Tuum, in Tabernacle Tuum.
Et in tree you are returned to Adem, the way to the back of the
kingdom. And fide parti di citara Deus, 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 par et espice sanctum mea et par recompense.
Spirit in Deo, holy man, come to the living, throw it to our Moses, may it be his
grace. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancti.
Supidero et in particular, in the temple, in the sacred or sacred Lord.
In tuoi vodat abite.
Adem, the way to
Ajutorium nostrum, Domine Tuum.
Vigilatio Celestem.
Confiteo Domine Tanti, et Maria Sempre Virgine, et Mihaelia Pantae, et Patrisme. Sanctis Apostolis Petro et Paulo, et Sanctis et Dominus Patris, qui ab ego vivimus cogitatione verbo et opere. Mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ideo pecum, et Maria Sempre Virgine, et Mihaelia Pantae, et Domine Battista. Sanctis Apostolis Petro et Paulo, et Sanctis et Dominus Patris, ora pecum, et Dominum Deum nostrum.
Thank you.
Matthias Sancti Evangelii secundum Luca. In illo tempore facta est contentio inter discipulos, qui seorum videretur esse maior. Excitatem eis, Iesus, reges gentium dominantur, deorum et hypotestatem abram superius benefici votantur. Posatem antic, sed qui maior est in vobis fiat sicut minor, et qui precessor est sicut ministrator. Nam quis maior est, qui recumbit, an qui ministrat, non qui recumbit. Ego artem in medio vestrum sum sicut qui ministrat. Posatem estis preparansistis, mecum in tentationibus meis, et ego dispono vobis, sicut disposuit mihi pater meus regium, ut edatis et vivatis super mensam meam in regnum meum, et sedeatis super tronos, judicantes duodecima tribus Israel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear faithful, today is a feast of Saint Apollinaris. He was a bishop and a martyr. And I thought for today, I found to give you a piece of history. So this is from the breviary, and it's some of the oldest documents in the church. And there are in older breviaries a longer reading, so I'll translate this as I go, but to tell you a bit about this saint, and think of it this way. This is the treasury of the church, the history of the church. The saint we have today, this saintly bishop, was ordained by Saint Peter, and he was sent on a mission by Saint Peter. So this is a man who knew Saint Peter, worked for Saint Peter. And so I'll just give you what it says in the breviary of the church. So Saint Apollinaris, martyr. He came from Antioch to Rome with the Prince of the Apostles, that's Peter, who ordained him a bishop and sent him to Ravenna to preach the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. So if you look in Italy, if Rome is, Ravenna is pretty much the opposite of Rome, so it would be on the east coast of Italy. And there it says, the breviary continues, because he converted many in this city to the faith in Christ, he was arrested by the priest of the idols and cruelly beaten. Through his prayers, a noble man of that city, whose name was Boniface, mute for a long time, recovered speech. And his daughter was delivered from an evil spirit. These miracles rose up a sedition against Saint Apollinaris. He was beaten with rods, and they forced him to step with bare feet on burning coals. Because the fire of these coals was not burning him, he was chased away from the city. He hid a certain time with some Christians and then went for the region of Emilia. He rose from the dead, the daughter of a certain patrician, this patrician whose name was Rufinus. This miracle converted Rufinus's entire family to believe in Jesus Christ. The prefect of Emilia was greatly irritated at this, and he forbade him to propagate the faith of Christ in the city. But Apollinaris didn't follow his orders at all. And because of this, he was tortured on the rack, and boiling water was poured upon his wounds, and his face was beaten with a stone. And then he was loaded with chains, and he was thrown in jail. And 4 days after, he was put in a ship to send into exile. The ship was shipwrecked, and he ended up in Thrace. When the disciple of St. Peter, so Apollinaris, was in Thrace, the demon who had been given responses is in one of the temples there was mute, and this made the anger of the priest there rise against him, and then they tried to look for him, to kill him. And he returned to Ravenna, and the same priests from those idols were beginning to accuse him again. He was put in jail, but he escaped from jail. And this being known, the guards went in pursuit and beat him and led him as dead on the way. He was taken by Christians, and whom he exhorted to stay firm in the faith, and he left this city 7 days later, crowned with the glory of martyrdom. So this is what one of the oldest documents gives us in the church. And it is beautiful because you see our inheritance, you know, our heritage. This is a disciple of Saint Peter. And it's almost, when you hear his life, it seems like a continuation of Acts of the Apostles. We get the same type of miracles, we get that same type of burning zeal, and we get that same, all those miracles, raising people from the dead, breaking the idols, getting them to be mute, casting out demons. We see all these beautiful signs, and we see how God works through a mere man. This was a mere man. And look, everything Christ was able to work through him. And why in the end? Because he said yes to Christ. He said yes to Christ. And today in the epistle you've heard and in the gospel, it speaks a lot about humility. Humility. That's what our Lord says to them. You know, they are arguing among themselves, who is the greatest? And our Lord says, who is the greatest? Him who serves or him who is being served? And look, I came to serve you. So our Lord set the example, and humility, what does humility do in our souls? It allows us to say yes to God. And any obstacle that may be there, from pride says me, 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 the world, the narcissistic world says me, me, me. Humility says God, 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 and everything for God. So, what do we have today? What do we ask this saint today? That same grace, that humility in the form of a yes to God. Lord, whatever you want. And Lord, it is all about you. And notice, as we're sitting here, we're all facing the altar. What will happen on the altar? The sacrifice. And that's the perfect worship for Almighty God. Jesus Christ is offered on that altar for his Father, in testimony of love to his Father, in testimony of love to us. Every time you come to Mass, what do you assist at? Jesus's yes to God Almighty. And then he wants this yes to spread. And that's why he will unite you to himself in Holy Communion. So you can be with him and say yes to God. But that takes that humility. Humility is receptivity. It's our capacity to receive him whom we know. Without him, we can do nothing. So it's our capacity to receive him. And what a God we have, dear faithful. Always remember this. He's a God that says to us, if you're weary and burdened, come to me. I will give you rest. This is our God. So on today, the feast of Saint Apollinaris, may we ask for the right dispositions to embrace God as much as we can, to give him our yes. Saint Apollinaris, pray for us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Vobemus. Veritas mea et misericordia mea benedictus et in domine meo exaltabitur corpus. tiem absolucjonem, misjonem peccatorum vescovo, che quod vobis omnipotens et misericordiosus. Ecce, agnus Dei, ecce quitorit peccata mundi. Domine, non sum dignus, ut infra sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine, non sum dignus, ut infra sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine, non sum dignus, ut infra sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. us, for peace.
And the Christ is the
O Jesus, who has sent us from under the presence of the Lord, 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 the Fiecie obecni oraz umanus, wiadomym nazwom Jezu Chrystum, Filii Ubu. Gdy go bili te trenia, że unitat jest świetny sąd, gdy sprawodnia segura, segura. Dominus, do biskupu. Ite, misa. Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus, Dominus Vobiscum, Initium Sancti Evangelii, secundum Ioan, in principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat verbum, hoc erat in principio apud Deum, omnia per ipsum facta sunt, et sine ipso factum est, nic et factum est. In ipso vita erat lux sovinum, et lux in tenebris lucet, et tenebre eabam compeat verbum. Fuitum omissus ad Deo qui nomen erat Ioannes, Ic venit in testimonium, ut testimonium per iberet in lumine, ut omnes crederant per illum. Non erat ille lux, et ut testimonium per iberet in lumine. Erat lux vera, quae illuminat omnem hominem venientem in hoc mundo. In mundo erat et mundus per ipsium factus est, et mundus eo non coniovit. In propria venit et sui eo non regiuberunt. Quod potatem regiuberunt eum, deditet potestatem filios Dei vir. Isque credunt in nomine Deus, qui non ex sanguini, sinec ex voluntate clamat, sinec ex voluntate veris, sinec ex Deo nati sunt. Et verbum caro factum est, et habitavit in nobis, et vidimus gloriam tuus, gloriam quasi unigenitia Pater, plenum gratiae et veritatis. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, our banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn them, most gracious advocate, to thine eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray that our refuge and our strength look down with mercy upon thy people who pray to thee. And through the intercession of the glorious and immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, of Blessed Joseph, her spouse, of thy blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, and all thy saints, do thou mercifully and graciously hear the prayers which we pour forth for the conversion of sinners, and for the freedom and exaltation of Holy Mother Church, with the same Christ our Lord. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the root of souls. Amen. Most sacred heart of Jesus. Most sacred heart of Jesus. Most sacred heart of Jesus. Sorrowful and immaculate heart of Mary. Saint Joseph. Prayer to Saint Peter. Thou art the shepherd of the sheep, the prince of the apostles. Unto thee were given the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Thou art Peter. Let us pray, raise us up and beseech thee, O Lord, by the apostolic assistance of blessed Peter, thy apostle, so that the weaker we are, the more mightily we may be helped by the power of his intercession. and that being perpetually defended by the same holy apostle, we may neither yield to any iniquity nor be overcome by any adversity, through Christ our Lord.